think I knew I wanted to be a writer right from when I was about 6 years old. I loved reading. I loved playing all sorts of pretend games. I made up stories in my head, and then as soon as I could hold a pencil and print out a few sentences, there it was in a little notebook. And right throughout my childhood, I was just writing and writing. Here is my very first long story called The Maggots, which was about a very poor family. I even wrote about the same kind of subject matter when I was 9 years old with my illustration. I'm a bit of a hoarder and I've kept some of my childhood toys and notebooks and so it's wonderful for children nowadays, mostly with really elaborate bedrooms, to see just how simple my bedroom was. I shyly told my mum and dad that I wanted to be a writer, and they just laughed at me. At school, I don't think anybody really took me seriously, but very luckily for me, when I was 17, I saw an advert in a newspaper for teenage writers, and I sent them a story, and to my utter astonishment, they accepted it. They paid me £3, which wasn't a lot of money, but I was simply thrilled because it meant somebody was taking me seriously. And shortly after that, they actually offered me a job up in Scotland with the company. So right from the age of 17, I have actually been earning my own living by writing, which is wonderful. It wasn't until I wrote the story of Tracy Beaker 20 years ago that I really started to become well known. And this was a change of publisher and, wonderfully for me, the start of a really brilliant artistic partnership with Nick Sharrett, who now does all the covers for my books and all the illustrations inside. So they had, you know, wonderful appeal on the bookshelves and make children actually want to pick the books up and look at them. And things have just gone from strength to strength since then. I felt I was on to a good thing the moment I got the idea for writing about a fierce, feisty little girl stuck in a children's home, desperate to be adopted. Children like to read about naughty children, and yet I wanted there to be a certain poignancy about Tracy's behaviour, because she's only badly behaved because she's had such a tough start in life. Parents sometimes question whether such subjects should be in a children's book. Luckily for me, children really don't seem to mind at all, and occasionally something in a book might make them cry, and I say, "I'm so sorry, you know, I didn't mean to upset you too much," and they smile at me and say, "I like crying at sad stories." A few parents, not a lot, but a few, have objected, and I always write back and try to explain why I've written about a particular subject and why I think it should be dealt with as truthfully as possible. But I feel I need to write the way that I feel things in my heart.